My name is Stephen Fingleton. I'm the writer-director of The Survivalist. Well, my film is about a farmer who lives in an isolated stretch of forest, totally self-sufficient, growing his own food. But this is in a time of collapse. It hasn't fared very well for the rest of the world. He saw it coming, he was prepared, but the others weren't. And it's about a starving woman and her teenage daughter who discover his farm. They're desperate for food, for summer to stay. And he won't give them anything. So they offer up the girl in return for food, you know, an exchange. He accepts, but he's brought danger into his midst as they want to get rid of him so they can have the farm for themselves. So it's kind of like a three-hander Hitchcockian sort of suspense film, you know, set after the end of society. Well, first of all, it's entirely set in a forest. It's a very green apocalypse, as it were. I call it post-event rather than post-apocalypse. I was just interested in what people do when the vestiges of society are removed. I did a short film called SLR, which is about internet pornography and the choices people make online when they can act anonymously. And I think this is kind of an extension in a funny way. I do think our civilization won't last. I think when you look at the amount of resources we're expending, the huge increase in population, the lack of a handle we have on global warming, the lack of planning we have going forward, we bear more similarities to insects than the rational computers we see ourselves as. You know, and if you look at every civilization in history, it's thought it will be eternal, it will be immortal, and it's always proved not to be the case, except today. We are in a general civilization. Instead of one island collapsing because of a loss of resources, the whole planet is like Easter Island. So it comes from that. The scenario I depict has been quite heavily researched. It's based on the peak oil scenario of resource decline. And everything that happens in it is based on times of starvation in history. For example, Auschwitz and the choices people made in the extreme rations they faced and the desperate decisions in a climate of death. That was a big influence for me in making the film. I actually visited Auschwitz 2 weeks before I made it. What I didn't realize in the process of making the film was that people would view it as being very realistic as a post-collapse film. But that's something that's kind of unique about it, I can say in retrospect, is it really approaches the subject as a drama rather than as a setting or a premise for, say, a modern Western, as in Mad Max or other films. Well, Martin McCann is a very well-known actor among Irish film and television circles, perhaps not so much the general audience as yet, but he has a real star quality, a real charisma and power. What Marty brought was a kind of animalism and a raw honesty to the role that you just wouldn't get from somebody who was, you know, from a very very different background. He comes from a place, you know, where you have to be careful about the choices you make, and that comes across on screen. Mia obviously is a fantastic performer, very, very low key. She never raises the volume too much, and it's all not even in her eyes, behind her eyes. And she was someone who was so subtle, I had to ask my editor to make sure, you know, she was performing in scenes because it was so discreet. But she was delivering for the cinema audience. She was bypassing everyone else. She was going straight for that. Alwyn was just terrific. She was a theatre actress from Ireland with a huge reputation there, but again, less known to international film audiences. And she came through an audition process. And at the end of the day, you know, our financier said, once they'd seen everyone, they said, like myself, we can't imagine the film of anyone else. She completely possesses the role. She's so physically specific. We couldn't even get a body double for her because there's just nobody who looks like her or has her kind of feel. I think it's a film about universal themes, about the choices human beings make, and it tries to honestly approach that as much as possible. It's not a film without hope, but it's not afraid to look away from the dark things that happen. I think it'll actually really work across different cultures. I've seen it in several different countries now, you know, both coasts of America, you know, Switzerland, France, and now in London. And it's always kind of played the same. And partially that's because of the absence of dialogue, it will translate, but it's also because what it's tapping into is across cultures. Well, you know, I love being part of London. I had my first proper short film here in 2009, and so it's great to be back here with a feature. I'm delighted Claire has programmed it and has given it the kind of spotlight to be seen. It's a rightful place for it, as it were. It was a BFI production, so this is, you know, the BFI London Film Festival is the natural home. So it'll be interesting to see the public reaction tonight, and hopefully we get some more people along on Wednesday as well, where it's on again.